Hello everyone. Welcome back. I'm Lalit Singh. So now you have seen how exactly we can navigate through the screens, what are the different UX you have to apply on the screens and all. Now let's just see one of the more complex topic, that is RecyclerView. In this session, we are going to cover about what exactly is RecyclerView, what are the different components of RecyclerView, and how exactly we can implement the RecyclerView. RecyclerView is one of the advanced topics used in Android application development system, and all the corporate world are using the RecyclerView. You can even say that RecyclerView is the replacement for your normal list view. So why do we need RecyclerView? Well, with your RecyclerView, you do not have to initialize all the 1,000 objects altogether. What you're gonna do is, you are going to initialize only few more objects. Let's say your user can only see 5 objects, and you are going to initialize few more objects to recycle them. So every time you scroll now, your items will be recycled with those objects. And that's how your RecyclerView can be more efficient as compared to your list view. Let's see how exactly it really works, and what are the components which really works inside the RecyclerView. First comes the data. Data is what you want to show on each and every record or on each or every item. Second, the RecyclerView view itself. Now, a RecyclerView can be a scrolling list, can be a grid view, can be a staggered view. Now, that staggered view or grid view or list view are actually managed by a layout manager inside the RecyclerView. So if I'm using a list view, if I'm using my RecyclerView as a list view, then I will be using a layout manager known as linear layout manager. And if I'm using my RecyclerView as a grid view, then I will be using grid layout manager. And same goes with the staggered. Then I need a layout also, layout file. And that layout file is used for each and every item. How exactly my each and every item inside the RecyclerView gonna look like? Let's just talk about a list. Inside each list, let's say I'm just putting one text view and one image. So each row will now look like a text view and an image. Text view and an image. Text view and an image. So that layout I will be designing inside one XML file, that is a layout file. Next, what you need is an adapter. As you are going to deal with the data also and layout also, so you need a class or intermediate class known as adapter, which you have already learned about in your UI control. That adapter is a class which holds everything together and then applied to a view to get the data or get the result populated in a particular view. So here also the adapter will be a RecyclerView.adapter, and I will get the data and layout file inside it, and I will be populating my RecyclerView into my data into my RecyclerView. A view holder. What exactly a view holder does? It initializes all the items which are there in your layout only once. And that's the reason RecyclerView efficiency is more as compared to list view, because it initializes all the items which you require in each row only once, and they can be reused. Now, this is a high-level diagram for RecyclerView. You can say it as a block diagram also. In this, you can see that you have a main activity, and inside your main activity, you will be putting a view, RecyclerView. And that RecyclerView, inside that RecyclerView, there will be a layout manager. It can be a linear layout, it can be grid view, layout manager, or it can be a staggered layout manager. If you are using list view, linear layout. Grid view, grid layout manager. Or staggered view. Staggered view is which doesn't have any dimensions like grid view. It can be created in any dimension. That's what a staggered view is. Now, after that, you need an adapter class also, which you will be connecting to your RecyclerView to populate it. What exactly your adapter class will actually do? Your adapter class, inside your adapter class, there will be a view holder. And your adapter class will take inputs as a data. I mean, whatever the data you want to populate, first thing. Second, there will be a XML file also, or a layout file, which you will be attaching to your adapter also. And once you attach your data and XML part, and you initialize your view holder, then you attach your adapter class to your RecyclerView, and you will be able to see your RecyclerView. Layout Manager helps you to put the item views of your recycler view or inside recycler view at their correct positions. So if you are creating a list view from recycler view, you will use a linear layout. Grid view, grid layout manager. Staggered, staggered layout manager. Adapter class is actually responsible for populating your data plus your XML file, that is the layout file. And then inside the adapter class, there will be a view holder also, which will be very crucial to initialize each item or each component which you have defined in your layout file. Let's say you have an image and a text view. You will be initializing those components inside your view holder just once. And then that adapter class will be used to attach to your recycler view. Let's just talk about again view holder. Like I was saying, view holder class will be used to initialize each and every view component which you have defined inside your layout file just once. You can even make them clickable and place the listener inside your view holder to handle them. But this is the class where you will be initializing your views. Let's just see how we can implement that. First, you have to include the dependency of RecyclerView, because RecyclerView you won't find in your standard SDK framework. It was included in your API 21, so you have to include the design dependency plus app compact support library, that's of course. And then you have to add the RecyclerView to your layout file or XML file, or even then you have to add your RecyclerView to your activity layout file, wherever you want to show your recycler view. Next, you have to create your XML layout for each row, what you want to put in your each row. It can be a grid, it can be a list, or it can be staggered. Then enter the, then create a new class for your adapter and extend it with recycler.adapter. And inside that adapter class, create another class that is called inner class and extend it with recycler.viewholder, where you will be initializing your views just one. And once you do all these things, then in the onCreate, you just have to set up your recycler view with your adapter and layout manager, and you will be able to see your recycler view. So this is how you add the dependencies. If you want to add a recycler view dependency, this is how you can add a dependency com.android.support.recyclerview directly from your Gradle build system, build.gradle file. You can directly add it from build.gradle file, or you can go to your projects, or you can go to your project structure, and from there you can also add the dependencies. We will see that in practical. Now, this is how you add the recycler view to your XML layout file. As it is a support library view. So you will be adding it with the help of support library file. And you will be adding an ID to it, and you will be giving the width and height, just like any other view. Now, there will be a layout file which you will be creating for how you want your each view to be represented. For example, let's say for our example purpose, we will be creating a list view. So for each list view, let's say I want just one text view inside that list view. So I will be creating a XML file, root layout will be linear layout, and then there will be a text view only. Now let's say I do not want just a text view, I want an image and two text view. Like you must have seen in your WhatsApp or in your Facebook Messenger, there is an avatar and then there is two text views. So for that purpose, the same file will be edited how? In above, there may be a relative layout, and below there will be an image, and then there will be two text views. Now that's what we are going to see in our practical demo also. We are going to create a recycler view with that kind of layout in each row. And to implement this adapter, we are going to create a class which will extend recyclerView.adapter, and then we are going to create a generic type also, which will tell what is the name of inner view holder class inside it. It can be anything. In my case, I'm putting word view holder. It can be my own view holder also. And then you have to just define this word view holder class as an inner class inside this adapter class. And here, inside this class, you can create the constructor where you are passing the data, from where you can pass the data, what you want to attach with your adapter, what you want to show in each and every row. And so you can pass it as constructor. Now, because you are extending adapter class, it is an abstract class. So you need to implement some callback methods. So what are those abstract methods? First is known as onCreateViewHolder. Second is inBindViewHolder. Third is getItemCount. Now let's just take a look at each one of them. onCreateViewHolder is the method where you will be initializing your viewHolder class. And how exactly you are going to do that? First, to do that, you are going to inflate your XML, that is layout XML file, which you have created for each row inside this method first. How do we do that? We have inflator classes for this. So which kind of inflator classes I will be using? I will be using layout inflator class and inflator dot inflate and give the r dot layout dot whatever the name you have given for your layout file and pass the view group as parent and make it false. You do not want to attach your parent with your layout file. So just put it false and then it will return you a view object and save it in a view object. And after that, you can return a viewHolder class by calling it new, whatever the name of the class you have given. In my case, WordViewHolder. It will return you a viewHolder class object. And in that, you can pass the argument as view object. Now you have everything in your viewHolder class. Before we go and check out our viewHolder class, let's just see how we can bind our data with our view components. So we already have a holder object here, that is view holder object here. All I'm gonna do is holder dot whatever the text view you have defined inside your view holder and set that text view. If there is an image view you have defined, holder dot set the object of image view dot set image resource. And accordingly, wherever the data you have passed at the time of creation of your constructor of your adapter, that data you are also going to pass here. Last is get item count. Here you have to put the length of your recycler view for how many times it will be iterating itself. So you can use one of the data you are passing and put it as use his length. So this will be the inner class that is view holder class. So I can call it my own view holder extends recycler view dot view holder, and inside this. You can, if you want to handle the views also, like buttons or the images you are putting or text view you are putting, if you want to provide the handlers to them or listeners to them, you can even implement the listeners inside this class. And let's say there is a text view inside this class and you want to handle that text view. First of all, you need to initialize that. So how do you initialize? You already know whenever I'm going to create this class or whenever I'm going to initialize this class, we are going to pass view as an item. While I'm passing view as an item, that item is containing all the components which I have inside my layout file. So I will do find view by ID, but item view dot find view by ID because everything is inside that view now, and give the ID to that text view and it will give me the text view access. After that, if you want to handle them, you can just directly set onClickListener and go on with your handlers. So that was how you set up your recycler adapter class. Once you set up your adapter class, all you have to do is now put this or set this adapter class to your recycler view. So for that, you will come to your main activities on Create. First of all, you get the access of your recycler view by using findView by ID, and then you initialize that adapter object. And then you set this adapter object with the recycler view. And one last thing which you need to do is set the layout manager. If you are using a list view, it will be a linear layout manager. If you are using a grid view, it will be a grid layout manager. And that's it. That's all you have to do. And you will be able to see your recycler view in action. Now, I know recycler view initially seems to be a lot to take in. But once you start doing the practical part, once you start getting into the each and every piece or each and every component of this recycler view, you will able to make sense out of it. So we will see this whole thing in practical also. So if you want to learn more about the recycler view classes and view holder classes or adapter classes, you can follow the following links. Next, we are going to do the practical for RecyclerView. Thank you.